Hi, I'm Chris with Splunk Education. Splunk visualizations help to display data visually, express ideas more clearly, see relationships or trends, and help draw conclusions from the data. But first, you need to structure that data in specific ways, depending on which visualizations you choose. Transforming commands such as stats, chart, and time chart convert event data into statistical data tables. These tables are made up of one or more series of related data points. The number of series and the corresponding data structures created by the transforming commands determine the type of visualizations that can be used for any given set of data. The data you might use in one visualization will probably not work in another. Let's go through a few examples to understand an effective approach to working with visualizations. The first question we should ask is, what story are we trying to tell with our data? What visualization best tells that story? And what is the best way to search for that data? Let's say we wanted to show total sales for the last 24 hours. We will run a transforming search using the sum function of the stats command, which will result in a single value. This might be useful in a dashboard with either a gauge or a single value visualization. It might be a quick indicator as to if we reached our sales goal for that day, but it doesn't tell us much about our sales in general. So let's ask a different question. We know our sales total for the past 24 hours, but how does it compare to the past week? We'll change our time range to search over the last 7 days and use the time chart command to better display a comparison. Switching back to the statistics tab, we see that our search has generated 2 series, one consisting of a timestamp, in this case days, and a sum of our total sales by each day. Let's see how they map to a visualization. While the single value will show the last day in the list, sparkline, and trend, it's still not the best visualization for what we want to show. So we ask ourselves, what visualization will best tell the story of our sales over time? The time chart command results in time on the x-axis by default and total sales on the y-axis. A line or area chart might be a good option. Looking at our chart, we can easily see the changes that happened between days, as well as the direction of those changes. Now we know about our total sales, but how is each product doing? Is one product doing better than another? Does one sell more than the rest on any given day? To find out, we can easily break down the total sales values by product name. The result is a series for time and one for total sales for each day, segmented by product. While the information is there, it's not easy to read. By switching to the column chart, it allows us to see more clearly how sales varied over time and how each product did on a given day. Let's take things up a notch. How do the total sales for each product compare relative to the units sold of each product? Do some products sell more units but make less money, or vice versa? And how do we best show this? We'd like to compare the relative value of total sales versus units sold. We do this by using the stats command and adding a count of the product IDs. When we run our new search, the result is 3 series. In this instance, a line or column chart won't give us any insights into our data. A scatter chart, however, will allow us to quickly compare each product and where its sales numbers rank. As you can see, understanding what story you're trying to tell about your data is essential in deciding how to structure your searches and what visualizations you can use. To continue your journey learning about Splunk, we suggest you check out the documentation, watch additional videos on the Splunk How-To channel, or register for courses from Splunk Education. Thanks for watching.